Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, we are driving relentlessly towards the end of the evening. I'm sorry to interrupt your drinks. I am sorry to interrupt your drinks. But our special guest this evening he's rushed back from a very important engagement because we've got something we'd like to tell you about. It's like announcer-geddon this evening. We've got another thing we'd like to talk to you about. It's quite exciting, and to tell you what it is one of the people I think is one of the best friends of the festival, the creator of Canabalt, the creator of this year, the Hunger Games iOS title Girl on Fire. He's here right now. He's going to join us live from Austin in the United States of America. Please give a disproportionately large welcome. Some of you might have met him before. Try and still seem interested. Please welcome Mr. Adam Saltsman. It's Adam Saltsman! Adam, say hello.
Oh, hey, everybody.
He's here. It's Adam. Adam, how are you?
I'm doing well. How are you?
We're very well. I'm all right. You all right? Not you, them. Are you okay? They're all right. It's been a good evening. Adam, last time we met, you weren't a father. Now you are a father. You look well.
Thanks. I don't remember very much the last 18 months, but it's been really good.
So what's been happening? So last time we saw you, so you've been to Game City now twice, right? So the first time Canabalt had just come out.
Just out, like 2 weeks before or something.
Well, before, right? And we did the thing in the Indian restaurant mm-hmm. with the curry and the Canabalt mm-hmm. and the tournament, and that was good.
Yeah.
And you came back. Was it the following year you came back?
Yes. Yep.
And that was when you did the thing with the.
We did the idea bucket.
That's right. So people remember this, but there was a bucket, both like a literal and a.
I'm just thirsty. It's just water. It's
no,
cool.
It's fine. It's right. It's right. It's not. It's fine. It wasn't weird. It wasn't at all distracting. So there was a literal and an actual bucket into which members of the public, predominantly kids, it's fair to say, put ideas for games, and then you stayed up scanning.
Yeah, I was with some brilliant volunteers and some brilliant help and a multitude of scanners, and I still have glitter embedded in the speakers of my iPhone from scanning night.
The lesson for that was don't let the kids also use glitter in their illustrations if you're going to try and scan them afterwards, because it causes problems.
It was awesome.
But then with Rebecca Mays, the celebrated singer, songwriter, video game critic, you made a game in a working day, right?
Yeah. It was a little under 8 hours, and it was super intense. And we ended up including about 100 different pieces of artwork that kids had drawn from the day before, and a story idea that was dropped into the idea bucket. It was super intense. Rebecca's music was beautiful. It was awesome.
Right. Adam, are you going to come back to the festival this year?
I was thinking I might. I was thinking this would be a good year to do that.
That's good. I'm glad you said yes. Adam, what have you been? What specific video game, possibly one associated with Venus Patrol, the leading indie games games journalism site, have you been working on recently?
Well, we've been doing this thing that it started out not as anything particular, just an interactive sketch that was sort of inspired by Lunar Lander, the old arcade game.
Right.
Which had this great analog thrust control thing, and it's one of my all-time favorite games. And I wanted to mess around with some ideas that I had gotten while playing it in San Francisco back in March of, I don't know, 2011 or something, 2010 maybe. And the sketch didn't really go anywhere. I thought it was sort of interesting. And then this guy, Brandon Boyer, was doing this thing that he was going to call Venus Patrol. And he was running a Kickstarter, so He asked if maybe I wanted to make something that could be a Kickstarter prize. He's based here in Austin also. And I said, oh, you know, I have this sketch that didn't really go anywhere, but this would be a great excuse to try and finish it. And so I collaborated with a gentleman named Robin Arnott, who is probably best known for a game called Deep Sea, which is a game that you play wearing a blacked out gas mask, and there's no video. It's all sound. It's
right.
One of the scariest things that I've ever played, and really inspirational in a lot of ways. And he actually approached me and wanted to know if I wanted to collaborate on anything. And I said, Robin, I have just the thing. We should do this. And we did it. And it went out. Not that many people have played the game. It was a Venus Patrol Kickstarter exclusive, and it's currently exclusive just to Venus Patrol subscribers and Venus Patrol gallery events mostly.
We won't do this without your permission, right? We have a copy of the game with us this evening. Are you happy? Because we won't do it if you're not happy.
Oh no, right? that's fine.
Are
yeah,
you all
yeah.
right for these people to play the game later?
Yeah, on? Absolutely.
You sure?
Yeah.
All right. Just check.
I think that's cool. Is there any reason we shouldn't do that?
I don't know. It's your game. It's fine by me. No, I think they should.
Right. I think they should. Yeah. I think they should because we're hatching a plan with this game.
Right.
So
you had some aspirations for, because this is like particularly kind of rich atmospheric title, right?
Yeah. The idea is so I used to be a user interface designer at right. my desk job, and that's something that I've carried with me into doing game design. And if you've played games that I've made before, you probably noticed that. There's no user interface usually, or much of one. You know, Canabalt doesn't have there's a number. That's the user interface. Right. It's just not, I don't like user interfaces that intrude into the game. I'm a huge fan of Metroid Prime. I think Metroid Prime has fantastical user interface design. It's so well integrated. And so I wanted to do something, but Lunar Lander is essentially all user interface. That's all it is this sort of radar projection of a thing. And I really like that idea. So so all Capsule is, and you guys will see tonight, is a radar console for something that doesn't exist in a place that doesn't exist. And the only way that you can access the imaginary place on the other side of the radar screen is through the radar screen itself. So I don't know if there's a genre for this. I call it zeroth person survival horror, but that's not a thing. So that's what we built, but it seemed like, you know, you can play it at home on your TV with headphones in the dark, and that feels pretty cool, I think. Robin's sound design for this game is right. so phenomenal, and it really it helps you believe that there's something outside, something beyond this radar screen. But we thought, you know, maybe we could go farther than that.
Right. So we had a conversation. We were trying to, despite you being a new father, we were trying to tempt you back to the festival because we had some good times. Good times, Adam. And we wanted to see if we could it's fine.
Well, it's either that or just coughing the whole time.
That's fine. I mean,
it's up to you guys.
Yeah. We see if we could rekindle some of that. So, Adam, we said, do you have any ideas of anything that you'd like to do? And in previous years, you said, I want to do Cannibal Indian Restaurant. I want to build a game with some kids' drawings and glitter in a working day. And this year, you've come up with a particularly spectacular concept. Adam, do you want to unpack to everyone what you're going to be doing at Game City this year?
So what we're going to do is lead willing trainees off onto their own into an isolated, custom constructed environment and see if they can survive a sort of a special live version of Capsule.
A capsule.
Yeah, you will you will climb into a thing by yourself and hopefully, have an experience that's kind of different from a lot of other video games.
So we've been talking about this as being the world's loneliest, slowest theme park ride.
It's like
the Back to the Future ride for Kafka.
yeah. I think that's a really reasonable way to describe it. And it's hopefully it's not a completely different set of emotions than games normally do, but it's a game that's the game doesn't tell you a lot. There's no cutscenes, there's no tutorial, but there's a lot of things to explore. And I think exploring it on your own and figuring out some problems on your own,
right,
there's a sense of discovery that is something that I think a lot of us crave when we sit down to play some weird new thing. So I hope that this is able to enhance that.
So you're gonna come all the way to Nottingham, to this very room. We're gonna build a capsule. We're gonna lock people in it. How long does the experience last? 15, 20 minutes?
Yeah, I think we're going to, even if it's on the flight over there, I'm going to be kind of carefully doing sort of a director's cut kind of a thing.
Right.
The normal capsule experience is about 2 hours, and a lot of strange things unfold over the course of those 2 hours. But if we went that route, I think about 11 people would get to play over the course of the festival, which is not ideal.
It's not cost effective.
Yeah. No, not especially. Those 11 people would have a really good time.
Yeah.
But it's going to be sort of a special little sort of Cliff Notes kind of cut to the chase version of the capsule, which hopefully leaves people. I don't know. I hope it is on the base level. It's a fun, weird little diversion, and if it helps people think about interfaces and computer screens and the way that we interact with computer systems, then I could not possibly be happier.
That sounds like a liability. But we have so many this year that this is the thin end. So we don't have any questions for Adam Saltsman about this project or anything else. I know he's on a bit of a clock with this. Are you prepared to just wait and be locked into a capsule in 3 weeks' time? Brandon's coming too, right? I believe so, yeah. So Brandon Boyer from Venus Patrol is going to be here all week. Adam's going to be here all week. Are you talking about the Girl on Fire project too? You can be doing some other stuff while you're over here?
That's the plan. That's the plan. I hope that we can share some wisdom or lack thereof on some of those things, and maybe do some. Maybe we'll be talking about some Flash, just some general kind of like high level Flash.
So I was talking to these guys earlier on, about the school thing that's running throughout it, and asking if anyone will volunteer. Adam is coming from Austin, right, to volunteer to do some of this stuff. So, I mean, like, really? If you're in Nottingham already, you should be able, I mean, you really should be able to rise to do this. Don't you think?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Adam, thank you so much for joining us.
We are my pleasure,
very
as
excited
as
about the capsule. We'll see you in a few weeks' time. Should we have a Butterfinger tournament now, and then turn all the lights out and play Capsule? What would work better? So the thing is about the venue, there's some quite a lot of lights, and we're thinking we could probably turn them all out and just turn the whole just pitch black.
Yeah.
Put Capsule on really loud.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is that how you would recommend we play it?
I highly recommend playing it that way.
All right. I think we should do the Buddha Finger tournament now, because there's like a mug up for grabs. Well, I know. That's why I'm saying it's... where is the mug? Is the mug... Oh, so we're going to show you the mug. It's pretty exciting. Is it... Oh, someone's nicked it already. Yeah, yeah, it'll be fine. Adam, thank you so much for joining us.
Adam Saltsman,
you could shake his hand in a few weeks' time. Thank you so much, sir. Good night.